Welcome back. This is the RPG Chick, back for more Mass Effect. I've increased the dialogue volume by another 5, so it's 60 now, so see how it is. I forgot to do it last episode. I've been gradually increasing it, so I just want to hear their voices more. The music and such seems fine to me. Let me know if you guys, think it's too high or low or anything like that. And there's some other settings, too, as far as that. Sound effects. I figure explosions could be quite loud. Might as well leave it low. And I have the music, and there's no actually master volumes. It's just switched into these three. Oh, hold on. I did make that 30. And because I loaded a game, it went back to... I don't know. I did it before I loaded the game. Joker.
Boy, am I glad to be off of Novaria. I don't know which was worse, the cold or the corporations. One will freeze your balls off, the other will sell them out from under you. With all due respect, Commander.
Ship status report.
How's the Normandy performing? Is she everything they said she'd be?
She's the best ship in the fleet. If you've got a pilot who knows how to handle her.
Yes.
Balance isn't what you'd expect. Takes a while to get used to that. The Normandy's probably too much ship for your average Alliance pilot, Commander. Lucky for you, I'm anything but
average. I have to go.
Alright, see ya.
He's like... She just cut me off. Oh, gunnery station. Look outside? Okay, we're not actually looking outside, but... More information.
Faster than light drives, ship mobility dominates space combat. The primary objective is to align the mass accelerator along the bow with the opposing vessel's broadside. Battles typically play out as artillery duels, fought at ranges measured in thousands of kilometers. Though assaults through defended mass relays often occur at knife fight ranges, as close as a few dozen kilometers. Hmm. Most ship-to-ship engagements are skirmishes between patrol vessels of cruiser weight and below, with dreadnoughts and carriers only deployed in full-scale fleet actions. Battles in open space are short and often inconclusive, as the weaker opponent typically disengages. Once a ship enters FTL flight, the combat is effectively over. There are no sensors capable of tracking them, or weapons capable of damaging them. The only way to guarantee an enemy will stand and fight is to attack a location they have a vested interest in, such as a settled world, or a strategically important mass relay.
What if we target their FTL drive so they can't leave that way? Was there something over here we could talk to or look at? I saw something. Oh, it's just Joker again, I guess. So, let's see if anyone else has anything to say. Caden over here. That is funny. How did we just, like, approach ourselves and just stand there for a second? I'm listening.
I always make time for my officers.
Off the record, I think there's something wrong here. This Saren is looking for a lost mass relay to who knows where, but we can't get backup from the Council? Sorry, Commander. There's writing on the wall here, but someone isn't reading it.
What do you expect me to do?
We've got our orders. Belly aching won't change them.
I hear you. It just seems like a group that's been around as long as the Council should see this coming.
I agree.
It's funny, we finally get out here and the final frontier was already settled. And the residents don't even seem impressed by the view. Or the dangers.
Cute way to look at it. Well, I don't like these two answers, so yeah, it's a cute way to look at it.
Well, well. You're a romantic. Did you sign on for the dream, Malenko? Secure a man's future in space?
Yeah, I read a lot of those books when I was a kid, where the hero goes to space to prove himself worthy of a woman he loves, or, you know, for justice. Maybe I was a romantic in the beginning, but I thought about it after brain camp. Biotic acclimation and temperance training. I'm not looking for the dream. I just want to do some good. See what's out here. Sorry if I got too informal. Protocol wasn't a big focus back in Bot.
What did they train you for?
Tell me about it.
Biotic acclimation and temperance didn't last past the airlock. To the kids they hauled in, it was brain camp. Sorry, hauled in is unkind. We were encouraged to commit to an evaluation of our abilities so an understanding of biotics could be compiled.
Uh-huh.
There are worse results of accidental exposure to element zero in the womb. Beats the brain tumors some kids grew up with.
Damn corporations.
I heard all about that. How companies would arrange accidents to expose people to element zero.
There was never any proof of that. It's not what happened in my case, anyway. My mother was downwind of a transport crash. It was before there were human biotics, a little after the discovery of the Martian ruins. It only gets iffy around 63 when Kinetics was running out of first-gen subjects. Until then, they'd relied on accidentals. Of guys in suits show up at your door after school, and next thing you know, you're out on Jump Zero.
Sounds rough. Go on.
Jump Zero's a long way from home. What was it like?
The Grand Gateway to Humanity looks a lot better in the vids. Anyway, this was supposed to be a casual debrief, not a bull session about stuff that happened years ago.
Shepard, you really need to put on some powder. Well, I'm interested.
I wanted to get to know you a little better. That's all. Thanks for the talk, Caden.
Well, you're welcome, ma'am. You, make a habit of getting this personal with everyone?
What do you think?
No, I don't. We'll talk again later.
I'll need some time to process that, Commander. But, yeah, I'd like that.
I'm sure you would. Oh, brother. I wanted to tell him, what do you think? Not, no, we aren't, or whatever. Technology. Biotic training, okay. Biotic implants and amplifiers only provide the potential to create coherent mass effect fields. Whether biotics can actually do so is largely determined by their training. Biotics must develop conscious control over their nervous systems, sending specific electrical impulses to the element zero nodules embedded in their nerves. They are taught to use their implants and amps with biofeedback devices and physical mnemonics. Specific gestures or muscle movements fire the proper sequences of nerves to activate a certain skill. Conatics Industries pioneered biotic training with the Biotic Acclimation and Temperance Training Program. Although BAAT did not achieve the desired results, many techniques taught are still used today. Many human think tanks are trying to develop some form of biotic super soldier. Most are benign efforts to create more flexible troops. Others, less publicly known, are unapologetic attempts to create Nietzschean supermen. Mm-hmm. Anything else to look at here? That. Nope. So, yeah, let's go down then. Rex.
So, we've got Saren on the run.
Yes, we do.
It won't be long now. Saren's good, but I'm better.
Mm-hmm.
Good. He's rotten. To the core. I could tell as soon as I met him.
You knew Saren?
Why didn't you tell me this sooner?
Yeah.
I would have if I thought it was important.
Keep talking.
I'll decide what's important. Now tell me how you know Saren.
This was a while ago. A bunch of mercs were bragging about a job out near the edges of the Terminus systems. They said it paid well and the boss was never around to ride them. They said he was looking for more men, too. So I checked it out.
Saren recruited you?
I didn't know Saren was openly recruiting mercs.
It wasn't that open, and he only showed his face once. We'd been raiding ships in the area for months when we took out this massive cargo freighter. Our biggest haul yet. I was on board checking bodies for valuables, looking for some extra credits. That's when I saw him.
What was he doing?
What did Saren want with the ship?
I don't know what he wanted. He was just moving through the ship, watching.
Hmm.
A couple of the mercs called him by name, but he never spoke to them. Never spoke to anyone. I had a really bad feeling about him, so I got the hell out. Didn't even wait to get paid.
So that's it?
That's the only time you saw him?
Yeah. Didn't even know who he was. Still wouldn't if I hadn't joined up with you. But my instincts were right.
They were.
Every other merc on that mission turned up dead within a week. Every damn one.
I see.
So long, Rex.
Or so long. Ashley.
Commander?
How are we doing?
What's your opinion of the last mission?
You mean the Rachni, right? They were dangerous, Commander. They proved that 2,000 years ago. I think it was a mistake to let them go. But that wasn't my call to make. It was yours.
You're right.
You know, when we pick up that Asari scientist, we'll have to tell her we killed her mom. That's gonna suck. Just saying, Commander.
Can we talk?
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
Sure. I was hoping to get a minute of your time. Off the record.
Of course.
I keep an open-door policy. If you have any concerns, lay them on me.
All right. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but I'm concerned about the aliens, Vakarian and Rex. With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the ship?
It was Vakarian. Is that Tali? What, because they're aliens?
You don't trust their motives because they're not human.
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons.
Hmm. You don't trust aliens, huh?
You don't trust the Alliance's allies?
I'm not sure I'd call the Council races allies. We, humanity, have to learn to rely on ourselves.
By mistrusting our allies?
How do you get from relying on ourselves to mistreating our allies?
Yeah.
I don't mean we should mistreat them, Commander. I just think we should be prepared to go it without them. As noble as the Council members seem now, if their backs are against the wall, they'll abandon us.
Not necessarily.
I don't see that as inevitable.
Look, if you're fighting a bear, and the only way for you to survive is to sick your dog on it and run, you'll do it. As much as you love your dog, it isn't human. It's not racism, not really. Members of their species will always be more important to them than humans are.
Why do you feel that?
These seem like deeply held beliefs, Williams. What made you think this way?
My family's defended the Alliance since it was founded. My father, grandfather, great-grandmother, they all picked up a rifle and swore the oath of service. I guess we just tend to think of Earth's interests as our own.
Just shut up. You have to work with aliens.
All right, I can see where your concerns are coming from, Williams. But this is a multilateral mission. You're gonna have to work with aliens, like it or not.
She said it more diplomatically than me.
Commander. You say jump, I say how high. You tell me to kiss a Turian, I'll ask which cheek.
Thanks.
I don't think kissing Turians will be necessary.
You never know, Commander.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.
Garrus.
Commander, how are you?
Long time no talk to. You and CSEC?
Why did you want to be a CSEC officer in the first place?
That's a good question. There were several reasons, I guess.
Such as?
Like what?
Probably the same as most officers. I wanted to fight injustice, wanted to help people. I guess my father had something to do with it, too. He was CSEC, one of the best. I grew up hearing about his accomplishments or seeing his picture on the vids after a big arrest. He's taking my resignation pretty hard.
I can understand that.
That's tough. But you'd think he'd be impressed you're going after Saren.
My father's a CSEC man to the bone. Do things right or don't do them at all, he says. He thinks I'm being too rash, too impatient. He's worried I'll become just like Saren. He actually talked me out of becoming a Spectre when I was younger, for the same reasons.
His voice is very low, Garrus. It's kind of always bothered me. Spectre, no kidding.
You were asked to be a Spectre.
Well, I was targeted as a possible Spectre candidate. Me and about 1,000 other Turian military recruits. I could have received special training, but my father didn't like it.
He despises the Spectres. He hates the idea of someone having unlimited power with no accountability. He wouldn't like you, Commander. No offense.
Too bad.
Not all Spectres are like Saren, you know.
Of course not. But Saren's not going to play by our rules. CSEC's rules. If you want to nail Saren, you need to send someone who isn't restricted by policies and procedures.
Exactly. Such as myself.
You're a quick learner, Garrus. We'll beat him at his own game. It's the only way to stop someone like him.
I'm right behind you, Commander.
Okay, I got more Codex notes. Military doctrine. Turians. Although they lacked the brutality of the Krogan, the skill of the Asari, and the virtuosity of the humans, the Turian military has formidable discipline. Officers and NCOs are lifers with years of field experience. Enlisted personnel are thoroughly trained and stay calm under fire. Turian units don't break. Even if their entire line collapses, they fall back in order, setting ambushes as they go. A popular saying holds, you will only see a Turian's back once he's dead. Boot camp begins on the 15th birthday. Soldiers receive a year of training before being assigned to a field unit. Officers train for even longer. Most serve until the age of 30, at which point they become part of the reserves. Even if they suffer injuries preventing frontline service, most do support work behind the lines. Biotics are uncommon. While admired for their exacting skills, Biotics' motives are not fully trusted by the common soldier. The Turians prefer to assign their Biotics to specialist teams called Cabals. Command and control is decentralized and flexible. Individual squads can call for artillery and air support. They make extensive use of combat drones for light duties and practice combined arms. Infantry operates with armor supported by overhead gunships. Strategically, they are methodical and patient and dislike risky operations. Tradition is important. Each legion has a full-time staff of historians who chronicle its battle honors in detail. The oldest have records dating back to the Turian Iron Age. If a legion is destroyed in battle, it is reconstituted rather than replaced. The Turians recruit auxiliary units from conquered or absorbed minor races. Auxiliaries are generally light infantry or armored cavalry units that screen and support the main Turian formations. At the conclusion of their service in the auxiliaries, recruits are granted Turian citizenship.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
I want to see if I can get heavy armor for Rex. Nope, not here. Medium armor. Scorpion 4. Let me make sure I can use medium armor. What am I using now? This is light armor. I guess that's tactical? Well, he doesn't have the... yeah. Shield boost. Medium armor. Oh, wow. I have a lot to go before I can go there. I have to go... I need 2 points to tactical armor, and I need to go all the way up here to medium. I might end up doing that with my points. All right. I don't need anything from it. Maybe those licenses.
What are licenses? Why do you need them?
Manufacturers sell licenses. I already have several basic ones, but you'll need to buy more if you want me to bring... Many of the best licenses are hard to get, but they're well worth the cost if you can find them.
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
So where's his licenses? Did I buy him already? I don't even know. You'll see an option to buy here. Engineer Adams.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
I want to know more about the Normandy.
She's the best ship I've ever served on. Probably the fastest vessel ever designed. She's the only one using the new Tantalus drive core.
He might have told us about this. I don't even remember.
What's so special about the Tantalus drive core?
Proportionally, it's about twice the size of any other vessel. Not only are we faster, but we can run at FTL speeds longer before we have to discharge the core.
Fill me in on the IES stealth system. How does it work exactly?
You can't hide a ship out in space. They emit too much heat and radiation.
I remember that.
Sensors to... So our stealth systems trap the energy we give off and store... Eventually, the sinks have to be vented. More than a few hours silent running, and they overheat. Cook us inside our own hull.
There's no way for anyone to detect us?
A visual scan can still pick us up. Anyone looking out a window can see us plain as day. But you have to be pretty close to get an actual visual out in space. Most vessels rely on scanners. As long as the stealth systems are engaged, they can't see us. Not unless we accelerate to FTL speeds.
Yeah, I remember this, all this whole conversation.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Core charge status. Codex. Yeah, that was gonna happen. Drive charge. As positive or negative electric current is passed to an FTL drive core, it acquires a static electrical charge. Drives can be operated an average of 50 hours before they can reach charge saturation. This changes proportional to the magnitude of mass reduction. A heavier or faster ship reaches saturation more quickly. If the charge is allowed to build, the core will discharge into the hull of a ship. All ungrounded crew members are fried to a crisp. All electronic systems are burned out, and metal bulkheads may be melted and fused together. You don't let that charge build in. The safest way to discharge a core is to land on a planet and establish a connection to the ground, like a lightning rod. Larger vessels like dreadnoughts cannot land and must discharge into a planetary magnetic field. The ship passes the charge from the drive core to the exterior armored hull, then dives into the magnetic field. As the hull discharges, sheets of lightning jump away into the field, creating beautiful auroral displays on the planet. The ship must retract its sensors and weapons while dumping charge to prevent damage, leaving it blind and helpless. Discharging at a moon with a weak magnetic field can take days. Discharging into the powerful field of a gas giant may require less than an hour. Deep space facilities such as the Citadel often have special discharge facilities for visiting ships. Okay. Hopefully this guy will, you know, take care of this stuff and we won't have to worry about being fried alive here. Alright, let's talk to Tally. Boy, how rude. What's wrong?
Are you okay?
I don't know. Your ship is amazing, and your crew's been really great to me, especially your chief engineer. But I just sort of feel out of place.
Yeah, I can barely see her face there.
Normandy runs so smooth, it feels like we're not even moving. And the engines are so quiet. How do you sleep at night?
I swear I can see the eyes and the nose inside. So a rather biggish nose and small eyes. Is it too quiet to sleep?
The silence wakes you up?
Back on the flotilla, the last thing you want to hear is silence. It means an engine's died or an air filter shut down. I guess you don't have to worry about that here. But old habits die hard. But it's more than just the silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, I kind of miss them.
Hmm. You always camp out on the floor here. There's noise. You can hear the warp core or whatever you call it. In this game, you're homesick.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have till it's gone.
That's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them. but maybe they just wanted a different life.
But you're going back, right?
You do plan to return to the migrant fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually. But we have to stop Saren first. Otherwise, I might not have a home to go back to.
True. We've asked you about this stuff, okay.
I should go.
See you later.
Alligator. Back up. I think the only place we haven't gone is the medical bay. You know, this is going to be the entire episode, too. That's the requisition officer. Where's the... Talking to everybody takes time. Plus in all these codex entries. Medical is around this way. No loading. Is this where Caden is? Okay, so I've been back there. Oh, what's this? Oh yeah, take this. This dust just been sitting in here. It's much better than what I have. Katana 4, Scimitar 4, 164, 187. Scimitar 3 we already have. I'm gonna reduce one of these. In case someone else needs a Scimitar 3.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
How well do you know the Lieutenant?
I'd never worked with him before this mission, but he has an impressive service record, over a dozen special commendations. Tends to keep to himself, though. Maybe because of the headaches. It's not easy being an L2.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
She doesn't have anything new to say. Can we get some Medigel? Thank you. Oh, zero? Never mind. around this way? Oh, these are my own quarters. Nothing to see here. I'm not hiding any more stuff from myself. Interesting how the elevator only goes that far, but we have to run up the stairs to get to the bridge. And the door doesn't automatically open. It's restricted access. Alright. There's no one in the comm room. Let me just check it out. Yeah, that's actually where we just talked to the council. Over there. Okay, so destination. We will see you next time. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.